Okay, so I already have some Urban Decay Primer Potion on this eye. And I am going to put, now you can either choose to use NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk. I have here a sample primer that someone made. It's a homemade primer that one of my friends made, and she gave me a sample of it and I absolutely love it. And I'm just going to pat that on very sparingly on the lid itself. Once that's done, I am going in with my green palette from Wet n Wild and a flat shader brush. And this is what my green palette, you would have seen it in my last video where I did my haul. This is what it looks like. And we are going in with this second color down here, which is just sort of like a peachy matte color. And I'm loading that up on the brush, and I'm going to be placing this from the inner lid, and I'm patting it on so that we get the best concentration of color. Patting that on till 3/4 of the way towards the outer edge. So I'm going to leave the outer quarter of the eye free. And right now we're just placing color, so we don't have to worry too much about blending and stuff. Now I'm going in with the top color on that matte side, which is the highlight color. I'm picking that up on the same brush, and I'm going right up underneath my brow bone using this color. Now you don't have to use the exact same palette that I have. You can just try and find really good substitutions to the colors that I'm using. Obviously, if you're a bit darker than me, this highlight color will definitely not work for you. So use your colors in accordance to what your skin tone needs you to use, as opposed to what I'm doing. Right, so the next step is actually taking our Vanity palette from Wet n Wild, which looks like this, and we are going in with this matte medium color here, the middle color. And I'm picking that up on a blending brush, which looks like this. I'm just picking up a tiny bit on that brush, and I'm going into the crease very roughly. I'm just placing that color in. I'm blending it a bit into the highlight color that I would have placed to the top there. And this is basically a transitioning color for us. It's not so much here to add a lot of color to the look, but it's more or less used as a color to help blend things out. Okay, so once that's placed there and I got a good blend going there, that's what it should look like. The next thing that I'm going to do is pick up, using the same brush, the same blending brush, I'm going to be taking this matte brown towards the bottom here of the same Vanity palette. And I'm going to be tapping this onto the outer edge, or the outer quarter I should say, that we left free. I'm just going to start by tapping it at first. And then I'm going to take it up into that crease. And start blending it out as I go. Now, this is where the variation comes in. You can apply this as heavily, obviously you can keep layering as you go along, and the more you layer is the more smoky the look gets, or you can leave it very, very lightly and it will be a very much suitable wood look. Right, so that's what we should have at this point in time. And we want to make sure we really pay attention to blending with this look, because it's going to make or break the entire look. Right, so once that's done, I actually, now this step is completely optional, but I love the way that a reddish brown looks, especially as a blending out color. This is a very old palette that I have, and this is actually the Coastal Scents, I believe it's the 42 matte palette. And there's this reddish sort of brown. Again, you don't have to use the exact same thing. I think Sasha has a great one. The palette, the 120 palette that I showcased in my last video, has a great selection of reddish browns. Again, I'm just dipping the very edge of this brush into that, tapping off a lot of the excess, and just really going in here and blending out that brown color that we placed right in the crease. And it gives a lovely gradient effect. So you at this point in time, you can leave it at this, like this, sorry. And this would be really appropriate for work. It's great for something that you don't really necessarily want a lot of drama for, but it gives a nice pop to the eye. So you would go ahead and complete with your liner and your mascara and whatnot at this point in time. However, for it to be my signature style, I need to amp up the smoke just a little bit, because we all know that I love a smoky eye. So switching back to my initial brush, which is my highlight brush, my flat shader brush, sorry. I'm just going with whatever's left on the brush. I'm just blending out, once again, where the crease color meets that highlight color that we placed there. And I'm just taking it in towards the inner corner of the eye, just to smooth everything out right on the inside here. So once that's done, I am going in with the Vanity palette once again, and I'm going to take this shimmery vanilla-ish type color towards the corner here, and I'm picking up a little bit on that same flat shader brush, and I'm going right up underneath the arch of the eyebrow with this. We all know that I'm not too much of a shimmer fan, but I do like a little bit of sparkle on the brow bone and of course along the inner corner. So that's the other place that I'm going to be placing this color, right along the inner tear duct, just to give a little bit of pop there. And you want to be sure that you blend that out. Okay, so last things last for this look, I'm going to be taking a brush that is a bit smaller and a bit more compacted, something like this, or you can use a pencil brush. And I'm going in into that green palette again, and I'm going to use that matte black towards the bottom here. And this is where the smokiness comes in. So I just pick up just a tiny bit on the tip of this brush, and I'm going to just dab off the excess. And right along the outer corner, I'm going to create a small V that starts from the edge of my eye and goes up into the crease using that black. Then using the same brush, I'm just going to wipe it off. I just want to feather that color in there into the rest of the lid and just give it a nice blend so that we don't really have a harsh line. You can feel free to switch back to that blending brush from before just to give you a little bit more edge in blending. Has a flat straight edge to it, something like this. You can use an angled liner brush, whatever it is you're most comfortable with. And I'm going back into Vanity, and I'm using the matte brown again from the bottom, and I'm picking that up. And you want to be sure you tap off the excess, because this will give you fallout if you pick too much up on your brush. And I'm running this underneath the lower lash line, very very close to the lashes. Taking it all the way in to meet the inner corner of the eye. So once I'm done with that, using that same smudge brush, I'm going to pick up the green palette once again, and I'm going to use the matte black in that palette. And I am going to place it underneath my lower lash line, just like we did with the brown, but I'm going to stop about halfway with this black. Kind of concentrating the darkness and the smokiness more towards the outer edge of the eye. That is basically it for our eyeshadow. At this point in time, I am going to use my black eyeliner. This is Urban Decay's 24/7 Pencil in Zero. And I am going to line all the way from the outer corner all the way in. the e.l.f. waterproof eyeliner pen. This is in black and it's basically a liquid eyeliner in a marker form. And I am going to start lining from the inner part of the eye all the way out towards the edge of the eye, and I'm going to make a little bit of a flick.